Hi, I'm Charlie Popeck, President of Green Ideas Sustainability Consultants. And our mission at Green Ideas is to keep our clients informed about what's happening out there in the green building industry and how they can apply it to their businesses. So there's a few things that have been happening at the USGBC over the last week that we think you should know about. After announcing that the fourth public comment period for LEED 2012 closed on May 28th, and that the final balloting would open for LEED 2012 on August 15th, and that LEED 2012 would be introduced at Green Build in November of this year, the USGBC did an abrupt about face and decided to delay ballot on LEED 2012 until June 1st, 2013. Now that's a year from now. They say it can potentially happen sooner if the members and the market are ready, is what they said. They went on to state that we see this ballot date change as an opportunity to begin to refer to this next version of LEED as LEED version 4, not LEED 2012. This is good, I think, because when you label a program like this with a date, immediately the next year, it's outdated. So I really like the version concept. So remember, LEED 2012 and version 4 is the same thing. Just like LEED version 3 and LEED 2009 are the exact same thing. So in addition, the USGBC has also committed to a fifth public comment period, and it's scheduled to open on October 2nd, 2012, and it'll run through December 10th of 2012. The other thing that they had announced is that LEED 2009 and LEED for Homes will remain available for registration for 3 years so that stakeholders can make the switch when they are ready. The one thing I did not see in this announcement, and they were very unclear about this, as to whether or not the beta version for LEED 2012 or version 4 will be available for you to participate in. So you're going to have to stay tuned for updates on that part. So at this point in time, there's really no reason to rush out and register your project under the LEED 2009 program because LEED 2012 or version 4 is going to be introduced. We typically tell our clients to register at the current version if a new version is coming out, but we really don't see any reason to rush out and do that now because the current version will be available for at least 3 years. So that's our advice for you today.